about how to do the assessment of genital system. So as you can see in this video, I'm going to tell you about how to assess the male genital system. Okay, so let's begin with, as you all know, that this is a quite intimate like a examination. So in this there should be a chaperon present as like a suitable to the patient. If the patient is comfortable with the chaperon, so we can bring through them and we can make the patient comfortable. And always when we have to inspect and palpate the areas, we have to pre-warm our hands, we have to wash our hands, and we have to wear the gloves. Okay, so now what we are going to do, we are going to undress the patient. So for that, privacy is must. We always have to maintain the privacy. So now we are going to expose the perineal area of the patient. So the position given to the male patient is the supine position. Okay, so as you can see, we can inspect this like a male genital region of the patient very nicely. So what you are going to do, we are going to inspect the patient's genital region like thoroughly. We have to stand and we have to see for the like a inguinal region, we have to see for the like hair distribution of the penile region and any hairs which is present on the scrotal region, and then the skin of the anal. Okay, so what we have to do, inspect for any sore which is present, any lesion or any abnormal mass which is present on the penile region, on the scrotal region and the down region. Okay, so the color you have to compare, whether it is like a very dark red color, whether any discharge is coming from the urethra. Okay, so what I told you here in the class, that whenever you are going to like check the patient's penile region, so you are always going to see the skin region, as this is the skin of the penile region. So you have to always press it back, so whether the foreskin can be retracted or not. Okay, the skin should be always retracted, so you have to check that. Okay, and any discharge in this meatus area is coming, so that you have to take a sample. You have to take a cotton applicator, take the sample and send it to the laboratory for any examination. Okay, then now as you have taken the like a secretion from that, so now you have to check for any foul smelling secretion. Okay, so if it is there, so you have to mention in your notes. And this dorsal vein will be present on the penile region. Okay, that is the dorsal vein, and that is quite normal, so that you have to see for, and you have to pulsate. Okay, you can see it for pulsation, and you have to see for the, you can say, the glans region. When you're retracting the skin of the penile region, it should be smooth, it should not be having any lesion, it should not be having any kind of crack or bleeding. Okay, if it is there, or any sore or canker like of thing, or like abnormal mass is there, so we have to mention in the notes, as this is the suggestion of any kind of infection like STDs, sexually transmitted diseases, or it can be due to some other infections. Okay, then you have to look for the scrotal region. As you know, the left side of the scrotal is little bit lower as compared to the right, so you have to see that symmetry of the scrotum. Any like a lesion should not be there, scar should not be there, any abnormal swelling of the scrotum should not be there. Okay, and when you are palpating the scrotal region of the patient, so it should not be tender for the patient. Okay, and when you are going to assess for the penile region, you have to press it between the thumb and the forefinger, so that you can feel any kind of tenderness in that area. Okay, so that's how you are going to do. And you have to inspect for the anus region also, and you have to use your like another pair of gloves with that, so that you can palpate it and you can see any kind of hemorrhoids in this area. You have to check for the sphincter's function of that area, and whether the patient is any like incontinences there or not, so you have to mention that. Okay, and if the patient who is having some tender prostate gland or not, so you have to ask whether you are having some like a problem related to urination, whether you are able to start the urine, whether you are having the ability like you are having the urge to pass the urine but it is not able to do, so that you have to ask, so that you can make a diagnosis of prostate gland like a hyperplasia also. Okay, so you have to like inspect the area for any kind of abnormal, like you can say, mass, abnormal like scars and abnormal kind of lesions which should not be there. Okay, so the slit, as I told you, the urethra should be in the center, as if it is down, so it can be hypospadiasis. And if the urethra region is here, if the patient is passing urine from above of the penis, so it will be known as epispadiasis. So these are some congenital disorders which can happen to the patient that you have to check for. Okay, so that's how you have to assess the like a patient's genital region, and you are going to make the patient's like again covered, and you can remove your gloves and you can wash your hands. Okay, so that's how you are going to perform your male genital assessment. Thank you.